I've been working on with my team here, team of five, for a year now, working on designing an end-of-line braking system for a Zipline. We're working for a company based in Maui, and basically their current system involves having a person hold a rope attached to a braking block on the line. And so it's all based on person. All the braking is based on person. One guy just sits there and has to take the impact from people hitting again and again every tour. So they obviously wanted a system, some sort of improvement.
Put every idea you have down and then look at them. But in that brainstorming session, you never know where that'll go. There were 64 ideas that they had on this one piece of paper, and they were all upside down and stuff like that. It's a wonderful moment in time that they had all this brainstorming time.
We brainstormed lots of different designs at first and eventually narrowed it down to about four different designs, which included our final design, which is a turbine braking system.
You have a three-bladed metal turbine spinning in oil, some sort of viscous fluid. Then when the rider engages the same braking block they used previously, it pulls out a rope and spins that turbine through fluid. And just that fluid drag slows them down comfortably and reliably.
Yeah, pretty sweet.
It's spring break and you're in Hawaii. You've just launched yourself off of a zipline platform and are now cruising over a bed of sweet potatoes at about 20 miles an hour. But then you start to see the end of the line and you might be wondering, how am I going to break? And if you're Mira, you're a little worried. How do we break, Mira?
An important function of a braking system is to control the rider's deceleration. ASTM standards for amusement rides set a limit of 2 G's of acceleration for the riders. Once the rider is stopped, the system needs to keep the rider in place and not send them back out onto the line. And then once the rider disengages from the line, the system resets so that it can stop the next rider.
And the main idea here is that a weight, or eventually a rider, would come in and they'd engage that braking block and start to pull the rope out. That when that rope is pulled out, it spins the rope reel and then spins the turbine inside the fluid. And that's the fluid drag that breaks a rider or a weight.
Overall, testing was successful. A couple of the heavier bags did hit the end of the line and hadn't quite been stopped fully by our system. However, they were moving slowly enough and had been braked sufficiently that we felt that had they been human riders, they would have been able to stop themselves with their feet on the platform quite easily. And so we moved forward to testing with human riders on the next day.
Our traction system could reset in approximately 15 seconds, and our system overall cost was under $3,000 for installation, fabrication, and materials. Most importantly, our system will be implemented at Skyline.
It's kind of melancholy that it's over, and I wish these young adults the best in their careers, and I hope in some way that, that they'll take away something that we did together and it'll apply in their career.